How many hours a day do you spend on YouTube? This question was answered recently by a future consulting company. For me, the answer isn't accurate. According to this company's research, the global average time spent by a user on YouTube is 11 minutes 24 seconds in 2020. Remember YouTube? When it was first launched on Valentine's Day in 2005? Just a simple video hosting and search engine interface. See what it says. Your digital video repository. Looks really nostalgic. A year after its launch, YouTube was bought by Google. The platform was then linked to Google, which enriched it with lots of features and business value. Today, it is the single most used public SaaS service of a kind, generating a whopping yearly revenue of $19.7 billion. That makes it almost 12 times the amount for which it was purchased. Good business, I must say. And with this growth, the story doesn't end here. With the development of cyber-physical systems, artificial intelligence, and human augmentation, the whole game is up for a drastic change. 90s kids have actually seen the complete transformation journey of YouTube since its inception. And today, they are seeing YouTube running premium shows. Tech-savvy users are watching YouTube VR videos in Oculus. But I'm here to talk about 5 sophisticated YouTube features that will blow your mind by 2030. So let's get started. Soon your jeans and shoes will be fused with sensor technologies and will become valuable members of the IoT club. Predictions are at least 20% of the global population will start wearing connected apparel by 2030. This apparel will become a data source for collecting body dynamics, body temperature, external temperature, sleep patterns, geolocation, and more. This gives birth to new triggers for YouTube's AI systems by calculating all this information with recommended algorithms, resulting in video suggestions which might spike your interest or help you in that state. So don't get shocked if you see your personal assistant saving some suggested YouTube videos offline before you are about to enter a forest for camping. These videos could be a part of a curated collection meant for life-saving in some pretty odd situations. Not only this, you may also start getting video suggestions based on your activity levels. And getting health tips and diet plan videos suited just to your needs. That is, if you have subscribed to an advanced YouTube channel for health and fitness. What is the most inclusive sensual experience you ever had with a digital entertainment system? Maybe you are thinking of your last movie experience in a 4D Max theater that incorporates and synchronizes other sensations like wind, fog, mist, motion, and scent, apart from the video running on the 70mm screen. Now, even though scent is added as a factor, it isn't strong enough to remember as an experience. But when we talk about the future, anything is possible. Generating digital smell is what's commonly known as olfactory technology. This was first done in 1939 at the World's Fair in New York, but it lost traction because of low commercial value at the time. Today, we have a product like Cyrano, which provides a programmable interface to control the scent administration and release of relevant fragrances that help control the mood and emotions of the user. So, just like the regular sound buzzing speakers we use with a screen, these personal boxes of fragrance would also exist with TVs and smartphones. They will blast the air with the required smell. Don't be surprised in 2030 to see YouTube creators adding additional metadata with their videos, acting as a set of instructions, operating smell speakers connected to your devices and synchronized with time. Just as they do today, displaying the right captions as the video moves. Kudos to Internet of Senses. Hope you never click on videos about sewer systems with smell captions enabled. Have you ever seen white rats with electrodes shoved in their brains and controlled remotely with electric signals? Well, Elon Musk's Neuralink project can make that possible with humans. As per the futuristic startup company, robots will operate a small surgical unit that will implant extremely thin threads in your brain, just like a sewing machine. These threads can become the wired medium of transferring information and signals between the brain and computing interfaces, making it the most advanced BCM ever. These wired mediums are known as neural laces. Once they are in, the world of UI/UX will completely change forever. Without clicking any fancy buttons or typing the keywords, you can directly send the signals to your computers by just thinking about it. Let me make this easier to understand. The first step is to go for a surgery and get the threads implanted. Next, you need to install the Neuralink app in your phone or computer and sync the neural lace like you do with any Bluetooth device. After this, you will have to spend some time exercising with the app so your pattern of generating instructional signals can be understood properly by the app. Now, you are ready to use Neuralink control system. This app will have intra-device communication with other apps like YouTube, which will translate the brain signals to actual computer instructions, passing it to YouTube, ultimately controlling video play and surfing to find your choice of videos. With more than 6,500 languages spoken worldwide, communication can be messy. Still, we have managed to pick up English as an international language. We are attempting to use it everywhere, from schools to offices, so we can actually understand each other. But many times, you will find people still facing issues because of the way English is spoken. We call this an accent problem. By 2030, the customization scope will reach the level where you can select not only the language but also the accent you want to hear in your YouTube video. With fast, almost unlimited cloud computing resources and NLP algorithms getting better and faster, it will be very likely to see a real-time accent modification systems in place which can modify the audio stream live to alter the accent of your choice. I'm sure this will help our South African and Irish brothers boost their viewership for sure. How many times have you skipped important instructions given by your parents or officials regarding safety and security? I have done it a few times in my life, but not everyone can be that lucky. Some creative governments have worked a lot to develop short films, posters, and even memes to make people aware about all the dangers of specific situations. But some people don't give a damn. This can be changed with some methods to make people view compulsory videos before they board a plane, start a track, or enter a potentially hazardous area. By 2030, the integration between apps and the real world will be highly precise and operate in real time, thanks to the enhancement in AIoT technologies. With this integration, verification systems can work efficiently to make sure you have really watched the YouTube safety program before entering. This tech will also help enforce the needed rules and processes. Organizations or governments can legally rest assured the right information is not only provided, but also understood. I hope schools don't enforce this tech as a prerequisite before allowing students to be tested. Let me know what you think about YouTube in 2030. You can add more feature probabilities in the comment box. Maybe we can share our collection with Google sometime. Stay tuned and keep watching Robocial.